Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and hope you're having a great time. We're back with some latest space updates for you today, and we'll start with NASA's plans to dock SpaceX Dragon spacecrafts at Russian node. Then we move to SpaceX's upcoming Starlink launch, following an update on droneship's return following the DART launch. We'll end up with Blue Origin and Virgin Galactic's selection of astronauts for future spaceflights. Before we dig into the details, we're excited to let you know that we've launched our new channel, Defense Today, to cater your latest updates about U.S. defense programs and some global movements as well. Check the link description below to give it a look and please subscribe. Let's begin our first update regarding NASA, where they wish the SpaceX Dragon spacecraft to dock at the new Russian Prechil node in the future. On the 24th of November, Russia launched the new Prechil node to the International Space Station atop their Soyuz 2.1 rocket. According to some recent reports, NASA is now planning to use this Russian node as a docking port for multiple spacecrafts, including SpaceX Dragon and other U.S. spacecrafts. NASA is presently discussing and negotiating with the Russian space agency Roscosmos for an agreement which will permit spacecrafts of SpaceX and of other agencies, and also future vehicles, to dock with the port. The Prechil node arrived and docked with the space station just 2 days after launch, i.e. on the 26th of November. Prechil is a spherical-shaped, pressurized vessel with a width of 3.3 meters, and it weighs around 3,890 kilograms. It's basically an intermediate structure in between the station and the visiting spacecraft. Sources state that Russia plans to use this node for helping in further expansion of the Russian segment in the station. The U.S. space station segment has two ports available for using as an International Docking Adapter, or IDA. NASA is taking the decision to add a third International Docking Adapter so that the future congestion in the space station can be alleviated, and they can bring up more space companies for providing services. Already, the movements in the International Space Station have increased as SpaceX is sending crew and cargo missions to the station at regular intervals. SpaceX is also to perform multiple Crew Dragon port relocation maneuvers to prepare the station for arrival of other Dragons. Moreover, in the future, there will be addition of Boeing's Starliner launches and SpaceX's private mission to ISS, which will further put pressure on NASA's schedule. Thus, if another International Docking Adapter is available, then it surely maintains the flow of routine arrivals and departures of spacecraft. Prechil can be used as a docking hub in the future. Prechil has 6 docking ports, and presently it's docked with the Russian Nauka module. Prechil still has 5 docking ports free for receiving Russian spacecraft. Sources state that to use the Russian node for other spacecraft, some type of adapter will be needed to install on Prechil, so that any spacecraft with International Docking Adapter can dock with the radial ASPGB ports of the node. It's expected that NASA will provide the new IDA port, and Roscosmos will build the connective adapter for Prechil. If this successfully happens, then the delayed launch of Prechil will ultimately become a boon for the space agencies and launch service providers. Our next is based on the upcoming Starlink launch of SpaceX. SpaceX is going well for their upcoming Starlink 4-3 launch, which is scheduled on the 1st of December at around 6:20 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. To further prove their launch progress, SpaceX teams have sent their newest droneship, a short fall of gravitas, to the Atlantic Ocean for a Starlink mission that will break the company's record for annual launch cadence. SpaceX has launched 20 times in the first 6 months, but only launched 3 times in the entire third quarter of 2021. Now, Starlink 4-3 is presently the first among the 3 to 4 launches to be carried out in December 2021. Report says that Starlink 4-3 is SpaceX's 16th dedicated Starlink launch of 2021. It will carry 53 laser-linked V1.5 satellites, and the mark of 951 Starlink satellites will be reached since launches from the 20th of January. SpaceX has plans to complete one more dedicated Starlink launch in December, which may be either Starlink 2-2 or 2-3. If the launch is successfully carried out, then SpaceX will cross the mark of launching 1,000 satellites again in 2021. According to earlier FCC approvals, SpaceX plans to launch and operate constellations of 4,400 and 7,500 Starlink satellites, almost 11,900 satellites in total. It's estimated that if SpaceX can iterate the Starlink launch cadence of 2021 in upcoming years, then Starlink's first phase of 4,400 satellites can be completed by mid-2024. Still, reports say Starlink's Very Low Earth Orbit (VLEO) deployment milestones will be a massive challenge. Now, moving to our next update, we'll discuss SpaceX's droneship return with booster after interplanetary DART launch. On the 24th of November, Falcon 9B 1063 had lifted off from SpaceX's West Coast SLC-4E launch site to successfully launch an expendable upper stage and NASA's Double Asteroid Redirection Test spacecraft on their way to the interplanetary voyage. After the launch, the Falcon booster had landed on SpaceX's oldest droneship, Of Course I Still Love You, which was placed about 650 kilometers southeast of Central California coast. This was, for the first time, the Falcon booster performed a landing and recovery in the Pacific Ocean. According to some recent updates, Of Course I Still Love You droneship is safely returned to California port with the booster. The droneship was towed using a tugboat, Scorpius, and sailed into port of Long Beach. Report says the booster, B-1063, returned nearly 2.5 days after its touchdown. Report also says that both the fairing halves used in the DART mission were successfully recovered. As SpaceX's earlier and most experienced droneship, Of Course I Still Love You has supported almost 52 Falcon booster recovery attempts in the East Coast, of which 45 were successful, before it was transferred to the West Coast recovery fleet. As Of Course I Still Love You has been under operation since a long time, it's now underpowered and comparatively fussy to operate and maintain when compared to the new droneships like Just Read the Instructions and A Shortfall of Gravitas. Of Course I Still Love You's capability to support launches is not as fast as the newer droneships, so it fits well with SpaceX's California launch facilities, which are also relatively old and can launch only one Falcon 9 per month. In our following update, astronauts have been selected by both Blue Origin and Virgin Galactic for upcoming spaceflights of New Shepard and Spaceship Two. On the 23rd of November, Blue Origin announced the names of the astronauts for the next New Shepard flight. As per reports, Blue Origin's next New Shepard flight, NS-19, is going to be held on the 9th of December 2021. The launch will be carried out from the pad of Launch Site 1 in West Texas. This time, the New Shepard launch will have a full 6 crew to fly with. This will mark the first 6-person launch for the suborbital vehicle, which is its full capacity, as earlier 2 Shepard flights have carried only 4 astronauts to the edge of space. In this upcoming third crewed flight of Shepard, Blue Origin has 2 guests among the 6 astronauts. Interestingly, Alan Shepard, who was the first American to go to space in 1961, and on whose honor the Shepard launcher was named, his eldest daughter, Laura Shepard Churchley, has been invited to become part of the NS-19 launch. The second guest is Michael Strahan, who is a former professional football player and presently hosts the television channel ABC. After the first New Shepard flight, Strahan interviewed Jeff Bezos, and according to some reports, Strahan was approached by the company to become part of one of the New Shepard flights. Strahan had stated, "Without hesitation, I said yes. I just wanted to be part of it. I was really enamored by the first flight I saw." The other 4 astronauts have paid for their seats, though the amount's not known. Those 4 astronauts are Dylan Taylor, Evan Dick, Lane Bess, and his son, Cameron Bess. Dylan Taylor is the chairman and CEO of Voyager Space and the founder of a nonprofit group called Space for Humanity. Evan Dick is an engineer, investor, and managing member of New Jersey-based Dick Holdings, LLC. Lane Bess is the founder of a venture capital firm called Bess Ventures, and Cameron Bess is a content creator in YouTube and Twitch. Following Blue Origin's announcement, Virgin Galactic announced on the 24th of November that Keisha Shahaf of Antigua has won 2 seats in a contest. The contest was carried out with Omaze, a charity fundraising platform, and Space for Humanity. Shahaf would be the first of Virgin Galactic's 700 current customers to be from the Caribbean. The contest raised $1.7 million for Space for Humanity's Citizen Astronaut Program. Shahaf also said, "It was always a childhood dream for me to go into space. It's a very big, very beautiful adventure. And just to have the opportunity to do it, why not? So that's why I'm going into space." She also said that she hopes to have her daughter, who's an astrophysicist student, to take the other seat. Till now, Virgin Galactic has not announced the date of the upcoming Spaceship 2 flight. That's all for today, and oh yes, please don't forget to visit our new channel, Defense Today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.